cops kill a young woman in a mental health crisis. Let's put up her picture. Her name is Jada. Jada Johnson, 22 years of age, was shot and killed in front of her grandfather while having a mental health crisis. This is according to CBS 17. Rick Iwanski is calling for the arrest of the Fayetteville officers involved in his granddaughter's killing. Per the grandfather's account, the young 22-year-old Jada Johnson was holding a firearm but threatened to only kill herself, not the officer. She was suicidal. She was going through a mental health crisis. So officers arrived at the grandfather's home in response to a call about a break-in. The grandfather told reporters his granddaughter had suffered from a mental illness and was just released from a psychiatric hospital. Ms. Johnson had been convinced her ex-boyfriend was going to break into the house and try to kill her. Once officers arrived, the grandfather tried to explain, listen, my granddaughter is having a mental health crisis. He tried to explain. My granddaughter's having a bad day. She's having a tough time right now. But things escalated. The Fayetteville Police Department told CBS 17 the officers pled with Ms. Ada Johnson for an hour to try to get her to put down the gun and get the help she wanted. The grandfather called the incident egregious and said that the officer who killed Johnson should go to jail per the report. Let me say this. We've done so many of these stories where law enforcement, one, they're not trained to deal with mental health crisis, and that's a policy dynamic. Two, many of them lack the decency and humanity to just wait it out. I mean, goodness, I would wait 20 hours. I would wait until I just fell out and could not stay up to make sure somebody survived. They don't have that mindset, right? They got a shift to end. They come with guns rather than non-lethal device or even training, or maybe let's say a mental health professional. Somebody to actually talk to the individual who understands a mental health crisis. But instead, we have somehow decided in this country that we need to put all of our public safety trust in the police. They are not your public safety measure. So many black lives were taken by police who did not know what to do, what to say, or how to talk someone off the edge. The last thing a mentally ill individual needs is an officer pointing a gun at them. Reports say the North Carolina State Bureau of Investigation will be looking into the incident. Let me give you another situation that has recently come back to the forefront of the narrative. An inquest jury found on Wednesday that two Seattle police officers were justified in fatally shooting a mentally unstable, pregnant black mother of four inside of her apartment when she menaced them with knives. This was back in 2017. There was an investigation. Now they're saying it was justified. Once again, they did not utilize non-lethal devices, even though they yelled taser, they started firing a gun. There was no mental health professional negotiating at the scene. Why? Denver is among several US cities working to develop an alternative emergency responder model for people who are experiencing mental health crisis. As police officers fatally shoot hundreds of people experiencing mental health crisis every year, according to a Washington Post database of fatal shootings by on-duty police officers, since 2015, police have fatally shot nearly 1,400 people with mental illnesses. That's according to that database. Now, let me remind you, out of those 1,400, all of them should be alive, meaning they had no malicious intent to kill a cop. They needed help. They did not need a bullet. Now, if we're not able to look at the hard data here and realize that police departments must evolve to match communities that need certain things, if we don't realize the data is saying that what we have done in policing is totally adversarial to the protection of community, then nothing will. The data is right here. There are family members who are still grieving because they called 911 thinking 911 was coming to help their granddaughter, and they killed them. All right, Dina, thoughts here?
I've also covered so many cases like this, and a lot of times it is the family member who needs help, but they don't want that kind of help. And that is, you know, sometimes we kind of complain about lawyers and all of the how litigious our society is, but it takes often lawsuits and big money payouts for police departments to change, or cities, frankly, to want to allocate their budgets differently. Because we have a mental health crisis in this country. Guns are going to become even more rampant with the Supreme Court's rulings. Those two things are combustible, and we have to have a willingness to realize that absolutely somebody, a police officer with a gun, is not equipped to handle a mental health crisis. And a family may want protection from their family member, or may want help from that family member, and they have no place else to go. And that's a problem. That shouldn't exist. We have somebody you can call if there's a fire, right? We have some place to go if you need an education. Why do we not have some support system that a family member can reach out to when they are having a mental health crisis? That is an emergency situation, and there's such a vacuum for the support we're giving people right now.
Yeah, and a model that's already working is Ithaca, New York. I highlight them often. I had a great conversation with the former mayor of Ithaca, New York, who implemented these programs. But they looked at their data, they looked at their 911 calls and said, wait a minute, roughly 50% of our 911 calls do not even require an actual cop. So what did they do? They started creating a department that reflected the needs of the community. That's how you do this.